So my first CBC with my daughter was actually my first CBC too in Madison, Wisconsin. She was 3 years old. She still comes and joins me on my CBCs to this day.
Matilda, is that a crane? Crane. How does a crane sound? Yeah.
Do you know how many CBCs or Christmas Birdhouse you've been to?
Well, the one where I saw the chickadee, that was the first bird I identified by myself. Seven?
And how old are you?
10.
So I started birding with my daughter ever since she was really able to kind of walk. She's come along with me on many of my birding expeditions, including my Christmas bird counts and climate watch survey periods. And so together, it's one of the ways that we really love to experience the area around us. My grandmother has always been a birder. She studied ornithology and she was just really passionate about birds. And it was really important for her to teach me about the birds. Having that connection with not only the places and the birds that you love, but also the people in your lives and how you can share those moments together. And so for me, it was really important to teach her about the birds that she sees every day, just like my grandmother did. The Christmas bird count is a tradition going back to 1900 where folks across the hemisphere go out and count birds every December and January. There were 27 individuals that counted that first year in 1900. And I always think about how they probably didn't realize what they were starting back then in 1900 and how important the information that they collected over these Christmas bird counts would be into the future. Data from the Christmas bird count is really, really valuable. As a scientist, I can count birds locally in my backyard, but I can't go out and count all the birds across the hemisphere. And so it's really important to have those community scientists out there across the whole Christmas bird count, counting birds from Canada through the US and down into Latin America. It really provides information for us to understand how bird populations and communities are changing over time. And we're already starting to understand and see the patterns of these changes because we have that wealth of data.
Think you'll do Christmas bird counts when you're older?
I think so. I like seeing the birds. I like when I get to like identify them all by myself because it like makes me happy.
The Christmas bird count is sort of like a wonderful way for people to connect to nature and to be a part of something bigger than themselves.